Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can move an image on both a window and a canvas in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Alright, my fellow bros. I'm going to divide this video into two different sections. In the first section, we're going to move a widget within a window. And in the next section, we're going to move an image on a canvas. So let's begin by moving a widget within a window. So we'll need a window, window equals tk followed by window.main loop, and we'll also need to set some geometry for this window. Window.geometry, and let's make this 500 by 500. 500 x 500. And let's take a look. Okay, that should be a decent size. Let's add a label to this window. So I actually have a race car image that I want to use. If you would like an image, feel free to pause the video and download one. What I would like to do is create a photo image from this PNG file that I have. I'm just going to call this my image equals photo image file equals, since this is within my project folder, I can just list the file name. Otherwise, you might have to list the file path. And for me, this is called racecar.png. I want to add this image to my label. Not necessary, but it'll be helpful for this example. I'm going to call my label just a label. Label equals label. I'm adding this to the window. And I'm going to set the image to equal my image that I created. It's a photo image. If you do not have an image that you want to use, you can simply just change the background color. You could say BG, I don't know, red. Oh, then we need to place this, so be sure to do that. Label.place, and I'm going to place this in the top left corner. That is where x equals 0 and y equals 0. And then we should have a race car or whatever image you used and a red background. You can get rid of the background color if you prefer. That's just if you don't have an image to use, you can set the background color just for a visual to show you where the label currently is. Let's set some key bindings for this window. And let's add them maybe here before we create the label and our image. So let's bind the W key for up, S for down, A for left, and D for right. So we do that with window.bind. And we pass in an event as well as a function name. So we want to tie the W key to a function, and we'll call this move_up. And then we will need to define this. So outside of the window, let's define move_up, and this takes an event. So we'll place that as a parameter, and to move our label up, we're going to take label.place, and we're going to place this at some new coordinates. X equals the label's current position relative to the window that it's in, so that is label.wInfo_x. All right, so then for y, it's similar. Y equals label.wInfo_y, but we're going to subtract maybe 1. All right, so this is all we need. Although this is only going to move up. So I'm going to press W, and our label, our race car, or whatever image you used, is going to move slowly up. I'm going to increase this to 10, so the change is more drastic. So now our race car is drifting off into space. Let's bind a few other keys. S, A, and D. Sad. Alright, so S will be down, move_down. A for left, move left. And D for right, move right. We'll just copy what we have here and make a few changes. Let's begin with move down. The only thing we're going to change within here is in place of subtracting 10 from the Y coordinate, we're going to add 10. And with our race car, oh, I guess we have to define these. So let's do that real quick. So we have left, move left. We're going to subtract 10 from the X coordinate. And keep y the same. And then the same thing for move right, move underscore right. And this time we are going to add 10 to x, and y will stay the same. Okay, now with our image, we can move up, down, right, and then left. And why stop there? We can bind these to our arrow keys. So up is just up with a capital U. Down is down. These are all capital, by the way. Left is left. And then right is right. And now I can use my arrow keys to move this image. Now, for this part of the video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can move an image on a canvas this time, and not just within a window. But we'll need a window to begin with. Window equals TK, followed by window.mainloop. And we're going to create a canvas. Canvas equals canvas. We're adding this canvas to the window, and let's set a width and height. For the width, let's make this 500, and the height 500 as well. So this is an even square. And we'll need to pack or place this canvas. Canvas.pack should take care of that. And let's run this, and this is our canvas. At this step, we need to add an image to our canvas, and I have an image of a race car that I want to add. So I need to create a photo image from this file. So we can do that. Let's give this photo image a unique name. I'm just going to call this photo image to keep it simple. Photo image equals photo image, and I can list the file path or the file name. Since this image is within my project folder, I only have to list the file name, and my file is called racecar.png. This next step, we need to give our image a unique name, the image that's being added to the canvas. I'll call this my image equals, and we need to turn this photo image into an image added to the canvas. So we type in the name of the canvas, canvas.create underscore image. We first need to list the coordinates of where we want to place this photo image. So let's place this in the top left corner. That is where x is 0 and y is 0. And we need to set the image of the image that we're creating. So we can do that with saying image equals the name of our photo image. And let's see what we have so far. So this image is somewhat cut off in the top left corner. We can easily fix that by anchoring our image when we create it. So let's at the end add anchor equals northwest. So that should fix that problem. And we now have our image that we want to use. And to move our image, we can set some key bindings. So we type in the name of the window, dot bind. And we pass in two arguments, an event as well as a function name. Let's tie pressing the W key to moving up. So the first argument is going to be W, and the second is going to be a function name. So let's say move underscore up. And let's bind some other keys. W for up, S for down, A for left, and D for right. We'll need to define these now. So at the top, outside of the window, let's begin by defining move up. DEF, move up. This has an event as a parameter. And let's create the other definitions here. So I'm just going to rename these. So we have move up, move down, move left, and move right. Okay, now this next step. We can use the canvas's move function to move an image a certain amount of pixels on the x-axis and y-axis. So let's begin with move up. We type in the name of the canvas, dot, and use the move function. And this has three arguments, the image that we want to use, and this image is called my image, the one with the race car. The next argument is the amount of pixels we're moving this on the x-axis. With up, we can keep this the same, but on the y-axis, let's say we want to move this up 10 pixels, so that would be minus 10. And let's repeat the process for move down, move left, and move right. For move down, we're going to change y to 10. For move left, We'll keep y the same at 0, but we're going to subtract 10. And then move right. We are going to add 10 to where x is. And that should be it. So we can move up, down, right, left. And if you want to bind these to some arrow keys, all we have to do is just change the event so we can bind these to our WSAD keys, as well as up, down, left, and right. And this time I'm going to use my arrow keys. Up, down, right, and left. Alright, so that's a few of the basics of moving either widgets or images on a canvas or window. If you would like a copy of all this code for both examples, I'll post both of them in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of moving widgets and images in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.